Welcome to the PeopleSoft Campus Solutions PUM Image 30 Highlights. In this video, we'll provide an overview to the key features delivered as part of PUM Image 30. We'll cover updates to Fluid Course Catalog Search with real-time indexing, changes to US financial aid for aid year 2024-2025, student financial planning updates to the student leave of absence message, student financials tax updates, and finally, UK HESA updates for 2023-2024. Let's get started with enhancements to Fluid Course Catalog Search.
Welcome to Real-Time Indexing for Fluid Course Catalog. I'm Kevin O'Connor, Senior Principal Product Manager for Higher Education Development. What is real-time indexing and how does it benefit our customers? Well, real-time indexing, RTI, ensures that data is updated on the search server as soon as an application transaction is saved. Based on the volume of data under processing in the real-time indexing queue, the transaction update may appear to be real-time or near real-time. Have you ever heard someone in your registrar's office or scheduling office say, "Hey, I added a new course to the course catalog, but students are reporting that they don't see it in the Fluid Course Catalog search"? Or, "I made multiple changes to several courses and I'm not seeing those changes in the Fluid Catalog search results. Why is that?" Up to now, the response that you heard was probably ranged from, "I'm not sure why that's happening," or, "You know, I forgot to run the course catalog incremental processing index. Hold on while I do that." Well, those days are over with the introduction of real-time indexing in People Tools 8.59 and Campus Solutions PUM 28 with our initial release of RTI for class schedule search. Campus Solutions introduced this new powerful feature, which has enabled a student to search for courses or classes which are up to date in real time, ensuring that they are seeing the most up-to-date classes being offered for a specific enrollment period without the need to manually run any indexing processes in the background. In PUM 30, we are introducing RTI for Fluid Course Catalog Search. So now, when a staff member makes any changes to the course catalog, those changes will be seen by students doing a Fluid Course Catalog Search in real time. You're going to have a lot of happy students on your hands. Let's look at RTI in a demo. So for this demo, I will have two browser windows open, one for an administrator and one for a student user. I'll be adding a new course to the course catalog, History 115, the history of real-time indexing. But first, let me show you what it looks like for a student to go ahead and search for this new course. Remember, I'm going to add History 115. The student does a search for history, and you'll notice that there is no History 115 in the course catalog search results. Let's go ahead and jump over to our course catalog. I've already preset a course, History 115, as you can see. I have one offering. It's been approved. And I have one component, which is a lecture. The units for this class are 3.0. And so, as you can see, I haven't saved this course yet. Let's go ahead and save the course. And as I've saved that course, now as a student, I'm going to go ahead and run another search for history. And in real time, that student will now see History 115, History of Real-Time Indexing. So instantly in real time, the administrator added a course, the student sees that course and can get the information necessary to move forward with scheduling that course. If the administrator makes any changes, let me show you how quickly those changes are picked up by real-time indexing. I'm adding a new effective dated row for this course. So let's say we want January 1st, 2000. And I'm going to change the title to History of RTI. Okay, so I'm going to change that course title. I'm going to change to 4 units. And I'm actually going to add a laboratory to this course. And I will go ahead and save this course. So let's jump back over and see what the student sees. So let's run a new catalog search. So again, I'm searching for history, just very generic. So that's why we see so many search results. But now, as you can see, a number of things. Not only have the changes been picked up instantaneously by the real-time indexing, but as you can see, the title of the course has changed. Now we have 4 units, and we've added the laboratory to this particular course. So in real time, the student now doesn't have to wait for you to run any indexing processes in the background in order for them to see updates to the course catalog. Let's just do a quick summary of RTI. So RTI is fluid only. RTI, the class schedule search RTI, was delivered in PUM 28 as well as a follow-up PRP. Course catalog RTI is released in PUM 30, and all the documentation required is provided along with the PUM release for setup and the activation of RTI.
The U.S. financial aid updates include 2024-2025 aid year updates for FISAP and 2024-2025 IAM Cloud INAS connectivity setup. The fiscal operations report for the award year 2022-2023 and application to participate for 24-2025 FISAP has been updated according to the specifications published in the Federal Student Aid Electronic Announcement on June 9, 2023. This update will allow institutions to produce the FISAP report that can be leveraged during the FISAP report submission process in COD. Updates for the 2024-2025 FISAP report are cosmetic in nature. Table formats and NA values have been delivered in applicable fields where they were left blank in prior award year reporting. As part of the first phase of the 2024-2025 transition to the College Board's IAM Cloud INAS platform, Campus Solutions has delivered the IAM Cloud INAS Tester INAS REST Service URL endpoint and security setup. Institutions are required to obtain a certificate and key for use with the Integration Broker Gateway, onboard with College Board to obtain their institutional specific INAS REST Service URL endpoint, complete INAS REST Service endpoint and security setup within Campus Solutions, and perform an IAM Cloud INAS connectivity test. IAM INAS institutions are strongly encouraged to complete this setup and testing prior to the 2024-2025 IAM Cloud INAS PRP that is targeted to be delivered in October 2023. To use the IAM Cloud INAS tester, institutions will first need to obtain a SSL certificate and provide that information to the College Board. The Cloud INAS integration implements Mutual Transport Layer Security, MTLS, for encryption and authentication. Institutions will need to import that certificate and key into the Integration Broker Gateway key store within Campus Solutions in order for MTLS to work. Detailed instructions on how to import your certificate and key can be found in CAM Doc ID 2849047.2, INES Institutional Methodology Web Service Integration. After importing your institution's SSL certificate and key, but before testing your IAM Cloud INES connection, you will complete the INES REST service URL endpoint and security setup, leveraging the REST-based URL information received from the College Board as part of their IAM Cloud INES onboarding process. After those steps have been completed, you will be able to test your connection to the College Board's IAM Cloud INES platform via the IAM Cloud INES tester. Please note that this test will not perform or validate the 2024-2025 IAM INES calculation. KM Doc ID 295-2880.1, Testing Connectivity with the College Board INES Cloud Service for Institutional Methodology Calculations, will provide detailed information on completing your INES REST service URL endpoint and security setup, provides a sample input JSON request file to use for connectivity testing, and a copy of the June 8, 2023 presentation on the IAM Connectivity Tester Certificates and INES REST Service. We also wanted to make sure that our customers were kept current on the Campus Solutions plans to support the Consolidated Appropriations Act from the Department of Ed. We want you to be aware that there is a doc ID in My Oracle Support, which we update frequently to keep you aware of our planned deliverables. This doc ID includes information on the changes being delivered for the next phases of the FAFSA Simplification Act implementation, including SAI, the Student Aid Index. I also wanted to make you aware that the HUGS Financial Aid Advisory Group consults with development on interpretation and design of the new capabilities, and then they communicate out their findings and their knowledge to the financial aid community. So we hope with both sources of information, you will be able to feel informed and stay informed on what we are doing in Campus Solutions to support this significant update to financial aid. For PUM Image 30, a new processing option has been added to the CS-SFP integration setup to support Campus Solutions holiday schedules by academic career. Users can now choose to have a single institution-level holiday calendar or assign a calendar for each academic career. The Student Leave of Absence Message, STLA, handler code was updated to read the new setup option. This update also includes a change to the way the CS holidays are reported in the Student Leave of Absence Message. Currently, the STLA handler creates individual entries for each day of a break. For instance, Spring Break 2024, which may take place from March 6th to the 10th, has 5 entries, Spring Break 1, Spring Break 2, and so on. This is not the desired format for consumption by Oracle Student Financial Planning. The handler will now combine the consecutive breaks into one entry with a total number of days attribute total days on break, indicating the total length of break. The student career term data is used to determine the applicable holiday dates. In this sample XML, the student is term activated in spring 2023, where the term begins January 3rd and ends on May 7th, 2023. There is no expected graduation term specified in the student program, and only holiday dates within the term range are included in the message event payload that was generated. You can see the sequence numbers were appended to the break entry description for consecutive breaks, and the spring 2023 break is now combined into one break entry where the total days on break is 8. In PI 30, we delivered 2 student financial tax updates. For the US 1090-AT, we delivered a new BI publisher template definition for tax year 2023. And for the Canadian T2202, we also delivered a new BI publisher template definition.
For our UK institutions, we have HESA updates. These include Updates to support the first student data futures return with coverage changes up to and including version 1.6.0 of the specification. Updates to support the ITT return for 2023-24, including changes to the email derivation to allow institutions to exclude university email addresses. Let me wrap up by including a list of useful resources for Campus Solutions customers. My Oracle support is certainly the primary site for official information. The PeopleSoft Information Portal is my go-to site for almost anything I need related to Campus Solutions. For interacting with Oracle and your peers, the Oracle Community site is ideal and supports the Ideas Lab site, where all your enhancement requests are logged and voted upon. If you're a HUG member, then you know the value of that community and its extensive file libraries. Finally, if you're working with a cloud product like Student Financial Planning, you'll want to bookmark Cloud Customer Connection. Thank you for listening to Campus Solutions PUM Image 30 Highlights, and we hope you will join us again.